back with another video, guys, and today we want to talk about solar for at least our 2022 Revel. We have it on top, obviously, but we also have our Jackery panels that we had from our Forerunner days. So we have two 100 watt panels, and as you guys have seen in the past, we do a lot of dispersed camping, and luckily we don't need a lot of the power most of the time, but as you saw in one of our previous videos, we had Starlink up. We didn't have any connections, so we had these up. And I know a couple of people were talking about power in our comment section, so we kind of wanted to go over it with you because it's not a straight shot of how you hook up external solar to the Winnebago Revels because it is a Zamp system, just like your solar control charger that's actually in the van. Mm-hmm. It's all done by Zamp. So you have an outlet here in the back that says Zamp Solar. And what you have to do is you have to figure out the reverse polarity in it, because if you just happen to shove something in there and it's not the correct polarity, you will blow your fuses, which is what we were worried about for, what, 2 years?
Yeah.
Essentially 2 years we were worried about that. So I'm the bronze, she's the brains, and so I asked her to figure it out, and she did. Mm-hmm. So we're going to go over how we figured it out, so that way you guys can do it too, because it doesn't come with a lot of power, the Revels in general, so to have that extra solar externally is awesome.
Mm-hmm. That's true for pretty much any RV. From what I did with my research, a lot of the polarities in the actual vehicles are reversed, so you have to make sure that you're making sure you're connecting the right way so you don't blow that fuse.
Yeah. So we're going to talk about, we only needed one tool for this, and then we ordered one part from Amazon, which we'll talk about those, so that way you guys can order them mm-hmm. and then have them set up the way that we do, at least for Jackery solar panels. For other panels, I do not know, but we had Jackery, so that's what we figured out.
So the tool we got is a voltmeter, and I had to do a lot of research on this because I'm not very familiar with it. But what we're going to do is take it and turn it on to the V with the line and the dashes to the 20 mark. I don't really know what they stand for, but that's where we're going to turn it to. And we're going to make sure both the leads are plugged in, the negative and the positive side. So we're going to take these, make sure they're not all twisted up, and we're going to take one lead and place it on the top end, one lead, place it on the bottom end of the solar plug here. Make sure the metal tips are touching the metal, and we're going to see what the read is here. So we're going to do this and then this. So that's negative reading right now. So I have the black, the negative on top, and the red, the positive on the bottom. So that is incorrect if we get a negative reading. So we're gonna switch it and put the negative on the bottom, the black one, and the red on the top, and we should get a positive reading. So that's the polarity of our vehicle. Positive on top, negative on the bottom.
Whew. So to begin with, we have a Jackery, like I had mentioned, with these types of ports. So this doesn't fit in, obviously, to the back of the van. We've snuck inside because it is still, it's 100 out right now. It's a little warm. So, but we wanted to talk about this and we wanted to do it in some shade. So we had to buy one of these adapters, which is an 8mm SAE, if I'm correct, and we'll link it below because you're going to need this part along with its adapter. So the thing is that you're going to get this part, right? You're going to plug this in here and you're going to think, oh, good to go. No, you need to check this first because this is what we did. So we're going to check the polarity in this before we just shove it right into the van, because that's what's going to blow your van.
All right, so we're going to test this. And it's going to give you a different reading, but it is truly red positive, black negative. One thing we've come across in my research is sometimes these are coded incorrectly as well. So you want to make sure that it is truly coded correctly with the wire colors. So since this only fits one way with the pin and the plug into here, oh, so if we were to use this one, it would be backwards and it would blow our fuse because the positive is going into the negative end. So what we would need is a polarity reverser. So what this does is that it connects to this side We plug it in. And now, when we connect it, the black will go into the negative side and the positive will go into the positive side into here, the way that it's set up. So we'll go ahead and plug it in. It's a tight fit in here. You want to make sure that it's in there all the way.
And then, as you guys can see, we have a splitter cable from Jackery, because we also have the 1,000-watt portable battery. So we have this extra solar panel, like we talked about, we have two. So we have a splitter so we can hook up both of these at the same time. So we've got this one in the sun right here. And then also on Amazon, I'll link it, but we got extenders as well too, so we can put them out further, especially when we're in like wooded areas. So there's an extender cord on these. I forget if it was a 10 foot or a 20 foot that we got for each one of these, so that way we could extend them all the way out. So we've got that one set up. We've got this one laying over here, which we'll probably move over here. Before we plug in the solar panels, we'll tell you what we're getting from the roof ones, so that way you can kind of see. So at the current moment, it is only pulling 1 amp with 13 watts of power. That's It'll one take, battery.
What did it say? It would take a day. Six minutes to charge or something?
Yep. So we've got still 1 amp and one day and still 13 watts. So because the panels are on top of our van, obviously the sun's not fully above us. Even if it is, it's only for a certain amount of time anyway. Mm-hmm. Our solar panels aren't obstructed most of the time, but when we go to plug in the solar panels, we'll show you such a greater gain of power just from having 200 extra watts. We plan on upgrading to a 200 watt panel, maybe with one of our 100s. Mm-hmm. So obviously you want to make these investments slow because these are not cheap. And so with that being said, we've got the two, at least right now, that helps us get more solar for what we want to do outside in the van, or if we need extra power and we're out boondocking. So going into our batteries, now that we've plugged in, we've got full sun right now because it is hot as forever and all the storms are coming later, like in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. But why we have the sun right now, because our batteries are draining so fast now that it's so hot out, because the fridge is on. And obviously we don't want to turn off because we're going out almost every weekend.
Yeah.
But when we go into our batteries, at the current moment, the way that we've got the solar panel set up, we're getting 6 amps and about 80 watts of power. We've gotten all the way up to 9 mm-hmm. before, which is great. So I'll check both of these batteries, but we're obviously seeing a positive in the power coming in. So this went from so many hours to just being the solar panels to being actually fully charging in a better aspect, where we'll actually be able to get it charged while it sits here. Mm-hmm. Now, this does not cancel out when we had Starlink, obviously. It pretty much just evened it out.
Yeah, we didn't use any power. We didn't charge at all. It just was...
Yeah, exactly. So, but this is a great product to have if you're out in boondocking or dispersed camping, you want extra power, you want to be able to use the solar panels that you already have. This is something that I know a lot of people talk about in the group and they have problems with, because it is not easy to figure out.
No, we were very scared to try it.
Mm-hmm.
It took a lot of research and a lot of time and convincing ourselves we can figure it out.
Absolutely.
Yeah. One tip for making sure your solar panels are the most efficient they can be, you want to make sure you're cleaning them, which we are really bad at doing. Especially if you're in an environment with a lot of dust, a lot of dirt, a lot of pollution. You want to make sure those panels are as clean as you can. So you can just use mild soapy water with a washcloth. Make sure you're not scrubbing them really hard to scratch the surface. If you want to do that, get rid of any debris and it'll maximize your charging time.
Yep, absolutely. Because we still have red Sedona dirt from ours.
I know, I just wiped it off with a dry towel and I'm like, good enough. But we should actually really wash them.
Probably.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Hopefully this was helpful for you guys. If you have questions down below, let us know. We'll try to figure it out, or if we know, hopefully we'll let you know. We'll place Amazon links down below. Obviously, with buying those, you know, it helps with our channel, mm-hmm. we, you know, you don't have to pay anything extra for it. They're just affiliate links that we have, but for the extenders for the Jackeries. And then I'll also put down for the reverse polarity connector. I think it's the 8mm SAE. If I'm correct, it actually comes in a 2-pack, so you'll get an extra one, which we put in the other solar panel too, so that way we can always have it in case one breaks for some reason. We've been waiting for this for a long time. We're glad we finally figured out. We needed to figure it out, mm-hmm. so because we're not always around shore power, but it is another good alternative to have, even for our Jackery that we plan on putting in here too. We plan on getting a 2,000 watt. That's the same as our inverter, so we know we can run most of our electronics or appliances that we need. Hope you liked it. Hope you enjoyed it, and we will catch you guys on the next one.